Okay, so let's do a pilot demo now. Pilot tone demo. And the idea, so the way I'm doing is that remember our transmitter has an inverse fast Fourier transform where we have all these quad modulated frequency coefficients coming in. So that's x of zero here, and that's an x of n minus one. And so they are all here quad modulated, but then one of them here, I'm just setting this to one. Yeah, so that's our pilot tone here. So that's our pilot tone. And all the remaining axes here, which are coming in, they are data quam modulated with complex numbers. Yeah, so that we have something like a plus jb, and then the A is either plus one or minus one, and the B is also just plus one and minus one. Yeah, so that we have a modulation which looks like that we can either be there or there or there or there. So we see real and imaginary. And so this one, so we have one pilot here. And so what the IFFT does is obviously generating on the other side our time series here. Let's call this here in this case xt of n for transmit, and so this is obviously a complex time series, which xt of n, which will just look some like pretty random style. And so and then this is transmitted to the receiver, and on the receiver side we have our fast Fourier transform here, FFT. And so here on the receiver side we hopefully see the same sequence here, but we don't know the start. Yeah, so this sequence will, if I manage to draw this roughly in the same way, this will start like this. So that's here, but the problem is here. So we need to detect the start. So this one here, so that's our start point here. And so we are doing this here because we know that on the output with all these x of 0 to x of n half, then somewhere in the middle there's our coefficient here, and this should be one. So that's our pilot tone here. Yeah, so this pilot tone should be one on the receiver side here. And so the idea is now that we shift around this trying to find the start point here by doing Fourier transforms until this output here turns exactly one. So we do different shifts until pilot is one or real valued. Okay, so let's try that. That looks a bit messy, and let's see how we can generate this. So what I've prepared here is our transmit signal here. So if I run this here, you see in the variable inspector here, we have positive and negative real values and positive and negative complex values. That is what I've described here, so that we have all these input values here. Here they are negative, positive. But now what we do is we sacrifice one of them here and set this to one and set this as our pilot. And so we could say x of 10 equals to 1. And so hopefully if we're checking x of 10, so that's now just the 1. And should, if we have a look at the different values, should just stick out somewhere as a pure real value here. Yeah, so there's nothing around here. And this is here our pilot tone. So that's our pilot, what I've injected into the system here, and we are transmitting that. And so now what we need to do is doing an inverse Fourier transform. So let's do an inverse Fourier transform. So we have our xt. IFFT, no, it's FFT, IFFT of X. So, and this is our transmit signal. This is obviously, if you have a look here, for example, it's the real values of that XT, some wild random time series here. Just by looking at it, it doesn't make much sense, but we know that if you're doing the inverse Fourier transform on this, we're getting our nice complex symbol here back, our quamodulated information back. And so now the XT is our transmit signal. And so as I said, on the receiver side here, so we don't know where this starts. Yeah, so on the receiver side, we don't know the starting point. So let's just simulate this here. So let's call this signal here XR of N, and the XR we add a certain bit here at the start. And to simulate this, we just I just add a few zeros to it. So let's say our XR or receive here append, and so let's add a couple of zeros at the start here, so let's say 10, and then we've got here our transmit signal. So let's see our XR. So we see here at the start of our receive, now we have a couple of zero values here. I could have also put some other random values in it. Doesn't matter. Just to basically make the start wrong. And so now on the receiver side, remember the next step on the receiver side is now doing a Fourier transform on the received signal. So let's see if we're just blindly now doing a Fourier transform on the signal from the very start. And remember, we have 1,000 initially, we know that the whole sequence is 1,000 samples long. So if we are doing numpy FFT of XR. And but then to be fair to the whole system, we need to limit it to 1,000 samples. And obviously we're getting loads of strange values out there. But we know that if this were the right start, then at the index position 10, that's the one where we put our pilot in, we should see just a real valued number here. But in this case here, there's also a complex value in it here. Remember the 10 here, this is our pilot we put in at the very start here. So this is here, remember this was index number 10. And then we would also would like to see here at the X of 10, you know, the same again. And so therefore this is no longer the case. But now we know I've added 10. Let's go back here to the visualizer. So I've added here, and this gap here was 10 samples. And so if I'm now searching around a bit here, so let's say I'm starting at 10 and go to 10,010. And so now we see here that's already looking really good. So we have here does our real value, and that's a tiny complex number. So we know that we are probably right with that. And obviously we know because I've added 10 samples, zeros in front of it. But let's see if I'm just shifting this one along. And we see already we have quite a large complex component here, and the real value is slightly larger. So let's just to see how it looks like if I'm sliding this here to 9. And again we see here now the real value is a bit smaller than 1, and again we're getting complex output here. Yeah, so the imaginary part is non-zero. And so and therefore you see already the strategy to find the start of the symbol is to minimize, in this case here, the imaginary component, which is definitely very, very small here, exactly at 10. And that's obviously what I've added very much earlier on here when I've done the append command here, that I've added 10 zeros here. And with that the you know, if I'm starting exactly here at this offset, then I'm arriving exactly again at the real value here. So I've found the right offset here. So we see that so simply by moving around here and playing around with the start on the receiver side here, I'm just moving around this start of the Fourier transform until the output here turns into 1.